whatever industry you're in, this works. This will work for you. Whatever industry you are in, this will work for you. It does not matter. What's up, Boss Bays? Welcome back to another video. I am spilling the beans today, honey. So as you guys can see by the title of this video is going to be about how I made my first $100,000 in 30 days, 30 consecutive days. Actually, it was about 23 days, but that's neither here nor there. I really wanted to put this video together because, you know, I just dropped the penthouse tour and all that good stuff. And then I did do a story time on like how I actually, you know, really changed my life, because a little over 2 years ago, your girl was broke. And I didn't even have a dollar to my name, like literally not even a dollar. So I told the story on how I actually changed my life from not having a dollar to my name to making 100 grand. But I didn't go in depth. Yeah, what I'm trying to say. I didn't go in detail on how I actually made the 100,000. So that's what we're talking about here, okay? If you guys want to watch the penthouse tour or the story time, click the link in my bio. Click the link in the description. I just wanted to kind of shed some light, share some inspiration. You know, we are going into the new year. Like, everything you guys want can happen for you. Like I said, 2 years ago, I was broke as fuck. So, you know, it's been a roller coaster though. But don't think your current situation is your final destination, okay? You just have to continue to believe in yourself, even when it's hard to do that with your current circumstances. And trust me, I know that shit can be hard, okay? So let's just hop right into it. Make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. If you are new here, welcome on in. Get comfortable. Now, real quick, let me just tell y'all that this is my personal channel now. I kind of changed up the content. I post vlogs on here, but I do have a channel specifically for business advice, free tips, free gems that I give on that channel. I will leave that in the description box as well if y'all want to head over there. Lots of new content coming soon. So, okay, lots of valuable information too, by the way. Like, shit that people don't give out for free. I always give out for free. I always find myself giving out shit that other people don't give out for free, because I just believe what you give out will come back to you tenfold, and I don't mind sharing, okay? First and foremost, let's hop into it. The 100 grand was made, and that was from digital products, okay? So for those of you who do not know what digital products are products that are not tangible. Products that consist of workbooks, ebooks, checklists, MP3s, courses, webinars, right? Anything that is not tangible. When you purchase something, you get it right away. And usually you get it in an email. So again, that is a digital product. Like, I mean, hence the goddamn name, digital. So no, you're not getting it in the mail. Nothing's being shipped to you, dropped off to your doorstep, right? That would be a physical product. A physical product are tangible items that you purchase that actually needs to be shipped and delivered to you. Simply put, okay? So I made my 100,000 from digital products. Now, this is not the story time. If y'all want the story time on how I went about doing all that, that video is in the description box. This is actually the step-by-step marketing strategies that I used to make it. Now, again, y'all, first, this is my last time saying it. This is not the channel for that. You can subscribe if you want to see my day-to-day life. But the channel for actual consistent business gems is in the description box, right? This ain't that. So first and foremost, this was not made on YouTube. This was strictly made using Instagram marketing. I went really, really hard on Instagram. And at the time, I only had 15,000 followers on the page that I was actually promoting my products. So don't think you need 100,000 followers to make $100,000. And everything that I've learned since then, you can make $100,000 with 1,000 followers, 50 followers, 100 followers, right? But we can get into that later. But the number of followers doesn't matter. Okay? But let me also say that I made this organic traffic. I did not run any Google ads. I did not run any Facebook ads. This was literally because of the rapport and the relationship that I built with my audience. And if I can do it, you can do it. Okay, boo? All right. So like I said, if y'all see me looking down, girl, I'm looking at my notebook. Look at all the freaking, these are all the notes I wrote so I can make sure that I didn't forget nothing. So like I said, I had 15,000 followers at the time. Some of y'all may consider it a lot. Okay. But like I said, you can make money with no matter what your follower number is. Get that vanity metric out of your head, okay? The first biggest takeaway I want you guys to make note of is to focus on a single product or collection. I was selling digital products during this time. That's what made me the 100 grand. The main product that I pushed was a webinar, and I focused in on this webinar, and I consistently promoted this webinar. I didn't try to promote, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 products at a time. And before y'all ask me what is the product, I'm not gonna tell you the product because the product doesn't matter. The product doesn't matter. It's all about the strategy. Like, I don't give a damn if I was selling socks, if I was selling tripods, if I was selling faux plants, DVDs, TVs, it doesn't matter. Once you have a marketing strategy down pat, it doesn't matter what the fuck you're selling. Like, I repeat, so don't ask me what was the product. Don't try to go and create the product and think you're gonna see the same results as me and you don't have the strategy down pat. And I don't want you to think that, you know, again, you need to go sell what I'm selling. You can sell whatever you're selling with these strategies and make money. Will you see 100 grand? Probably not. I don't know. It's based on your own efforts and da, 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 da. Okay, long story short, what I did, so go back to what I was saying, is I focused on a single product to push. I was promoting a specific product. Now, you can do this for a product or a collection. So, for example, let's say, you know, you sell candles and you have an actual candle collection that's for soil candles, right? You don't necessarily have to just focus in on one soil candle. You can just focus in on that collection. But you do need to have your focus product if you're trying to do the strategy that I am telling you guys about today, okay? Now, I was in my launch sequence for about 90 days. This is a very, very important step, but I'm gonna get into that just a little bit later. So make sure you guys watch the entire video, okay? So the next thing that's super important that has to do with my launch sequence was I was building hype and anticipation for it very nice and slow, okay? So you don't necessarily need to be in a launch sequence for 90 days. You don't need to, but me, I wanted to make sure, for one, this was something that my audience actually was interested in. This is something that they knew was coming before I actually dropped that I was doing it. And by the time that I was ready to sell tickets or, you know, drop the product, I had a group of people who I knew was money ready, like debit card ready, credit card ready. They was waiting on me. You don't never want to just, unless you have built a rapport and you got it like that with your audience, you don't just drop products and be like, go buy, go purchase. It doesn't work like that. You have to build up hype and build up anticipation for that product or that collection, okay? So again, I did this real nice and slow. My launch sequence was about 90 days and it worked out. Now, what I did during this time was engaged with my audience every single day. Every single day, I'm asking questions, I'm checking in on them, I'm responding to comments, I'm talking to them by name, I'm going above and beyond to engage with them. I was going live every day, I was posting free value, like this could include tips, gems, resources, whatever industry you're in, this works. This will work for you. Whatever industry you are in, this will work for you. It does not matter. You have to provide value to your audience. You have to identify yourself as an authority figure, or people aren't going to trust you to spend their money with you, and that's just real shit. Now, if you actually need help with engaging with your audience, you need help with creating content on your Instagram that increases people's likes, their comments, their saves, their shares, I actually have a series on how to beat the Instagram algorithm. I will leave that in the description box. The people who engagement went up over 59,000% just by changing up their content strategy. And it's really simple. It's a bulletproof strategy. Okay, so go check that out if y'all actually need help increasing engagement. If you don't, bypass that. But if you do, it'll change your life. Okay, so the next thing I did was build a wait list of people who were interested. So remember how I was saying during my launch sequence that I actually built up that hype, I built up that anticipation, you know what I'm saying? Real nice and slow. A part of that was creating a wait list. A wait list is telling somebody, hey, I have this coming soon. If you want to be the first person to know about it, click the link in my bio and sign up for the waitlist. That's what I did in a nutshell. So I was constantly promoting my waitlist. I was constantly talking about the product that I knew I was dropping soon and actually conversing with the people who were interested. Now, when you are doing the waitlist method, you want to provide some type of incentive, right? So I did early bird tickets. So the people who were on the waitlist actually got first dibs to this early bird ticket. People don't like to spend more than they need to. Like, that's just facts. You feel that way, I feel that way. If I can get a sale, if I can get a deal, that's what I'm gonna do, that's what I wanna do, right? Especially if it's something that I'm already interested in, something that I already want. You mean to tell me that I can get this at a discounted price? Then that's what I'm gonna do. Well, hell yeah, I'm signing up for the waitlist, right? So that was a part of my launch sequence, was actually putting together this waitlist of people who were interested. And this is so important, y'all. This is vital. You actually have to stay in communication with these people. You do not want people to just join your waitlist and then they don't hear from you until you're ready to drop whatever you're dropping. No. So I was sending emails 1 to 2 times a week to these people that were on my waitlist so they wouldn't forget about me, right? That's important. If I'm talking too fast, y'all, I apologize, but I'm super excited. I'm super passionate. Just about helping people get to the coins, y'all know this. And this strategy really set the tone for my business. And once I saw that it worked, all I did was keep implementing it, fixing it, tweaking it, making it better. So now we make even more money. Okay, so it worked, y'all. Try it out. Something that I mentioned a little earlier was that I was going live every day, right? So I was already used to going live, and lives are so great, y'all. This is again good for any industry because it gives your audience a chance to interact with you in real time. It builds up trust, it builds up authority. You get to talk to people, you get to answer their questions, you get to just chat it up with them, like, what the hell y'all got going on? You know, it just makes you feel like, it makes your brand comes off as a person, as a human, and people really connect with that. And I feel like nowadays, more than ever, it's super important to have that key component to your business of actually coming off as human. Nobody wants to do, you know, business with big brands anymore who don't have a face to their brand, or they don't really care about how their audience and their consumers feel about their products or about upcoming products or about how they're providing an experience to their customers. You know what I'm saying? So I doubled down on my live sessions and I posted more reviews. So like, one thing about me, I'm big on receipts. I don't give a damn if I can tell you I made this much money, this strategy works, I did this, I did that, if what I did can't be duplicated. And every single thing that I teach people can't be duplicated. And I really, it's a blessing from the man above that I have such a gift of teaching to where I can break it down in simple terms where people can understand and they don't necessarily have to make the same mistakes as me. So one thing about me, again, I'm big on receipts. So during this time, I was posting so many reviews, testimonies, receipts, to where people, they just like, it made no sense if they didn't join my waitlist. It made no sense if they didn't believe what I was putting out there to be true, because so many other people actually followed and listened and they got the results that they wanted because of it. You know what I'm saying? So now, if you guys do not have reviews, there's a couple things that you can do. For one, you can reach out to past customers. You can do case studies. You can get in different Facebook groups and kind of network and collaborate with other business owners, swap out things and get reviews. It's a lot of options in that department, okay? The next thing I did was I invested into influencer marketing. So after I was probably in my, I was still in my launch sequence, but I didn't launch yet. It was getting closer and closer to it. So I already had built up the hype. I built up the anticipation. I had a group of people who were interested. I had my reviews. I had my testimonies. My engagement was through the roof. Like, everything was perfect. Then I invested into some influencer marketing. Okay, and what this did now was just bring a wave of a cold audience. And a cold audience is people who don't know you, don't know nothing about your products or your services or whatever you provide or have to offer. And now they're coming to your page with brand new eyes. When you invest into influencer marketing, y'all, this is vital. When you invest into influencer marketing, it's so important that you account for that. If I go to somebody's page and they're trying to teach me, you know, how to do something, right? Well, how do I know it worked? That's the first question. How do I know this is legit? How do I know that it works? And who else has done it? I made sure all of those things were accounted for before I invested into influencer marketing. So now I got all these waves of new people coming to my page, and they were sold because I did the groundwork prior. You get what I'm saying? Are y'all picking up what I'm putting down? If y'all picking up what I'm putting down, can I please get a big bank in the comments? If y'all are picking up what I'm putting down, if this makes sense to you, just put big bank in the comments for me. Please, 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 okay? And like I said before, y'all, I don't post this type of content on this channel. If you wanna see more of this, I provide lots of free value on my other channel, also on my Instagram. So this is the norm for me. Forever putting y'all on game, because this is what I love to do, okay? So then the next thing that I did was I posted receipts again, but from me personally. So I posted receipts of the money that I was able to personally make with digital products, right? So remember how I was telling y'all that the way I made $100,000 in 30 days for the first time was with digital products. But I had to obviously say, okay, well, this isn't the first time I made money with digital products. You get what I'm saying? I make money every single day with digital products. Now, if you guys are interested in learning how to create digital products, anybody can do it. I don't care if you're a cook, a barber, a makeup artist, a beautician, if you clean shoes, it doesn't matter what you do, you can make money with digital products. I actually have a webinar for beginners where I teach you how to create them, how to come up with ideas for them, how to sell them, how to market them, how to launch them. It's literally 3 hours long. It's a lot of information. It's 3 hours long and it's only $100. But I do have a code for y'all. I have a code for y'all. So if y'all interested, check the description box. It's enough money out here for all of us. Seriously. All right. And I got a code. It's a 50% off code for y'all. So check the description. It's for the first 100 people. That's it. That's all. Scary money don't make no money. So I was posting receipts of all the money that I was able to personally earn with digital products. And then I was posting examples of digital products that others can create and the benefits of selling them. So literally, like I just said, y'all, anybody can create digital products. Your mama, your grandma, your sister, your cousin. And this doesn't have to take away what you're already doing. So if you have a 9-to-5, if you're in college, hell, if you know what I'm saying, you already have a business, you sell physical products or you provide a service. Digital products, it's just extra money. Like, it's just extra money. So I posted that. So for y'all, this could work out in regards to, you know, your business posting other people actually using your products. So the next thing that I did was actually collab with other people in my industry. This is so important because for one, you're networking, and for two, collaboration over competition always. Okay, but this also sets the tone for a brand new audience. And for one, they're getting to see you. So now you're exposed to this other person in your industry, to their audience. You're already starting out as this little bit of authority because even though they don't follow you, whoever you collaborated with on that Instagram Live or that Facebook Live or that Zoom call, they already follow that person. They already believe in that person, right? It already set you up with some trust with their audience. My live did really, really well when I collaborated with other people in my industry. It went really well. I think I did those like once a week leading up to the launch. And then after it ended, after my launch was over, I posted plenty of receipts, AKA reviews. So after people bought the product, I posted those reviews. So more and more reviews, the more social proof, the better. Yeah, because sometimes people are hesitant to shop with you. They wanna hear somebody else did it first. Y'all know this, cause y'all probably like that. Y'all probably the same way. And lastly, I wanted to share a little bit more about the launch sequence. So a launch sequence for me, this is how I plan out my launch sequences and also how I teach my mentees to do the same. It consists of 4 different parts. Okay, so you have your pre-launch, your pre-launch, the actual launch, and your post-launch. Now, if y'all wanna know what every single part entails, grab the webinar because I literally go in detail, but I'm gonna give y'all just a little bit. And that's to not focus on just launching. That's to not, you know, keep everything up under the roof and keep it as a secret until you're ready to tell the world. That's not how things work. For one, you have to make sure that your audience is interested in whatever you're thinking about launching. and then they know it's coming so they can prepare themselves, and you build up that hype, you build up that anticipation so you can sell out or you can actually have a great launch day versus barely making any sales because nobody knew it was dropping, right? And another key part of the launch sequence is the post launch. That's where you're actually studying your data. You're looking back at the analytics. What made sense? What was your conversion rate? You know, how many people actually came to your site versus how many people made it to checkout? That's all important need to know information along with a whole bunch of other stuff. But like I said, if y'all really want to learn, listen, you're not going to start out making 100 grand in 30 days with digital products. But hell, what's an extra grand a week or a month? What's an extra 10 grand? So if you are interested in selling digital products, you just want to make some extra income, or hell, you want to retire, quit that job, check out the webinar. It is extremely, extremely beginner friendly. Like, you could have not known what a digital product was today, but by the end of that webinar, you're going to be ready to make some money. All right. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, don't forget to go subscribe to my other channel. If y'all need any more real, raw, and transparent business advice on e-commerce stores, check out the channel. Lots of new content coming soon, so go subscribe, y'all. And follow me on the gram. I always post free gems there too. I just want to see all of us get this money, okay? Period. I also have a mentorship program if you guys are interested and really serious about actually growing your business. But listen, let me tell you this now. It is not for everybody because I am not for everybody. It's not for the weak, okay? So before you waste your time and mine, think about it, right? I'm going to take you through there, and it's a lot of work, but it's worth it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will see you in my next one. Y'all, go subscribe to the other channel because these videos will not be dropped here, all right? This is just my day-to-day, my vlogs, my life. But I did want to share this video on this channel because I dropped the penthouse tour and I had a lot of questions about what it is I do and what it is I sell and how I did it and all that. So I just wanted to clear up that, and y'all still not ever gonna know everything I do, which nobody should tell anybody everything they do. Everybody should have a little bit of mystery to them. But for the most part, I share a lot with y'all, especially to help the next person get to the next level. All right, so I'm out, y'all, and I'll see y'all in my next one.